Tensions appear to be escalating between the National Association of Driving Schools, NADS, and the Infrastructure Ministry. The association's vice president, Kingson Jean, says the association feels slighted that ministry officials have yet to meet with them to discuss their concerns about the oral format of the driving theory exam, which was officially discontinued on March 1st.
We believe that the ministry basically has no respect for our sector, in that we have written 4 letters to the ministry requesting to have a meeting with the chief transport officer or the permanent secretary, and to this date, we have not been able to meet with them, and it's over 2 months, going to 3 months, well, I think 3 months now, we have not been able to meet with them. An association such as ours, we find that to be totally disrespectful to us and the entire public on the whole. You could imagine if we cannot meet with the chief transport officer who's responsible for coordinating what takes place within the driving school sector, and persons trying to get a driver's license, files an individual on their own.
According to Jean, there are currently at least 50 license applicants who have attempted the theory exam without success and are waiting to take the oral exam. The delay is impacting their ability to do the practical test. Jean argues that the oral exam is vital for those with disabilities and others who have poor literacy skills.
Driving the practical skill is not theoretical alone, is a practical skill, and to understand certain things, sometimes a picture or diagram will better illustrate what you want to ask that student, and they'll be better able to answer that question. In the more developed countries, whereas they don't have an oral exam per se, but what they do is they have the theory test on computer, and with the computerized test, you will get pictures, diagrams, and videos to illustrate what they want from you. So it is basically an oral exam in itself. And with the computerized exam, you could choose whether you like the computer to read out the question to you as well. So if in those more developed countries they have an oral exam for theory test, why in a developing country we decide, hey, to ostracize certain people and prevent them from getting a driver's license? A driver's license really boosts our economy, and it gives people a sense of pride and development, a sense of achievement, and we don't want to be putting people back as a result.
At a pre-cabinet briefing on April 29th, the Infrastructure Minister, Stevenson King, addressed NADS's concerns, reiterating the ministry's position on the oral exam.
We stand behind the decision, and the method of what is called an oral exam is really not an oral exam, it's an oral discussion. And so if we're doing an oral exam, let us do an oral exam. If you come in to, into the ministry to do an exam and we want to test you orally, then we must test you orally. It's not supposed to be a conversation in which there is a discussion. They have written, they have not given much detail as to what their concerns are, but I'm hoping that very soon we will meet with them to hear their claim and to address the situation.
In any case, the National Association of Driving Schools has issued its final notice to the Infrastructure Ministry, requesting a sit-down on the matter.
This 4th letter we wrote to them is our final letter. If we do not get a response by the 30th of this month, we intend to take some drastic action, which we really don't want to do.
For the DBS News World, I am Zane Rompulus.